Hoi! Today I'm going to talk about Harry Potter in translation. As you might know, the Harry Potter books have been translated into at least 67 languages. Besides the English one, I've only ever read them in one other language, which is Dutch. And the Harry Potter books are actually what got me interested in translation. I have endless lists that I made when I was younger with all the Dutch and English names for people, spells, magical creatures. I never really went outside when I was a kid. These are book 4 and book 5 in Dutch. All 7 Harry Potter books are translated by Wiebe Budding. According to Wikipedia, Wiebe Budding translated his first book in 1978, and it was A Clockwork Orange. And the reason he made this translation was that his father, who was a poet, was originally doing the translation, accidentally threw it out and then didn't have time to do it, so asked his son for help. In general, translating a book comes with a lot of difficulties. Here are some things to think about. What do you do about names, puns, songs, cultural references? And as you might know, even the British version had to be translated into the American one, which is not called the Philosopher's Stone, but the Sorcerer's Stone. Besides the normal changes from jumper to sweater, there are some interesting differences. For example, in Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, the sorting of Dean Thomas is left out. While in the Sorcerer's Stone, it says, Thomas Dean, a black boy even taller than Ron, joined Harry at the Gryffindor table. And the British Jelly is changed to the American brand name Jell-O with a capital J. Now, the interesting thing is that there are no set rules for translation, so all the translators and all the different languages got to do whatever they wanted. So in the German editions, all the English names stay the same. Quidditch stays Quidditch. But there are some honorable mentions. For example, Sirius Black was translated to Sirius Schwarz in the first book when he's just mentioned casually, and Schwarz means black in German. However, in the third book, when he turned out to be a major character, they changed it back to Sirius Black. And my favorite one, which I got told about yesterday by a German friend, is that apparently the game Exploding Snap has been translated as Snape Explodiert, which means Snape explodes. So apparently instead of just playing a game of Snap, Harry and Ron are playing some kind of customized game about an exploding Snape. Another really difficult name was Tom Marvolo Riddle, which turns into I Am Lord Voldemort. Doesn't quite work out the same way in other languages. My favorite solution is definitely the French one, where Je suis Voldemort turns into the name Tom Elvis Jedusor. And yes, I said Elvis. But now I want to get to some of my favorite Dutch translations. First of all, we have Diagon Alley, which in Dutch is Weg is weg. Now the word weg in Dutch can mean both road and gone. So the word weg is weg technically means road is gone. Dumbledore was changed to Pergamentus, which is basically the Dutch word for parchment, but with a Latin suffix to make it sound more like a name. The Room of Requirement is called the Kamer van Hoge Nood. Kamer means room, and Hoge Nood means being in desperate need of something, but it also means really having to go to the bathroom. Which is fitting if you remember that the first time this room is mentioned is when Dumbledore finds it in the middle of the night when he was looking for a bathroom. Then we have Horcrux, which in Dutch has been translated as Gruzelementen. Gruzelementen comes from if you drop something and it breaks into a million pieces, but the word was slightly changed to have the word ziel or soul in it, so it's little bits of soul. It doesn't flow that well because there's too many open vowels in the word, but I think it's still pretty smart. And finally, we have the translator's favorite word, villa, which in Dutch is glamorgana, a combination of the word glamour and fata morgana, which is the Dutch word for mirage. Did you know that in the Dutch books, the note from RAB is actually from RAZ? That's because the last name Black is actually Zwarts in Dutch, and they basically have the same meaning. But finding all the acronyms in the different translations did kind of help us solve the mystery before the book came out. Also, did you know that Joe Rowling released an alternative title for Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows? Just so translators could have a title that they actually understood. The alternative title was Harry Potter and the Relics of Death, which was also used for the Dutch title. Now, what I want to know from you guys is, what languages have you read the Harry Potter books in? And what do you think about the translations you've read? Also, what is your favorite translation of a name or a made-up word in the Harry Potter books? I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll talk to you guys later. Doei!